What is going on, everybody? I'm back to talk about a new horror film that is a part of a franchise that I've seen every film in the franchise. And the reason for that is because the original film, Insidious, talking about the newest installment in the Insidious series today, I am a huge fan of James Wan's original Insidious. A few years ago, when I started posting on my channel consistently, really kind of the rebranding and launch of what my channel is now, it was one of the early films that I reviewed for the Halloween season. I love Insidious. I think James Wan did something really special with that original film. And because of that, it spawned a slew of sequels. And the second one was a direct sequel. The third and fourth ones were kind of offshoots that were related to the characters. And I haven't really been as excited for this franchise as I was for this film. Whenever a new film in the franchise was released, I was kind of just like, okay, whatever. Not really that big on it because I haven't really been all that impressed with the sequels since the original film. And knowing that Patrick Wilson was at the directorial helm of this one and that they were getting back the original cast members, I was very excited to watch this film. And the movie I'm going to be discussing today is Insidious: The Red Door. Insidious: The Red Door is directed by Patrick Wilson. To put their demons to rest once and for all, Josh Lambert and a college-age Dalton Lambert must go deeper into the further than ever before, facing their family's dark past and a host of new and more horrifying terrors that lurk behind the red door. So, as I said, was really excited to check this one out because Patrick Wilson was directing it, because we got the original cast members back, and I really enjoyed this movie a lot. It is not perfect, but I think that it is miles above the other sequels that we've gotten in the Insidious franchise, and I think that a lot of that has to do with Patrick Wilson being at the directorial helm. Clearly, him taking on this project means that he cares about these characters, he cares about this world, and I'll get more into it when I go in detail with the review. So, this film takes place 9 years after the events of Insidious Part 2. There's nothing acknowledged about Part 3 and Part 4, but the film legitimately starts with the very last scene of Insidious Part 2, where Carl is performing the memory-wiping ritual on Josh and Dalton, the father and son, who have experienced these things together. So we jump forward 9 years into the future. Josh's mother has passed away recently, and believe it or not, him and his wife have gotten divorced, and you can kind of see the tension between the family. You can tell that he's kind of separated himself because he doesn't really remember what happened, and it's all kind of a blur to him. He's trying to get his own life together, and Dalton is about to go away for college, and Renee, played by Rose Byrne, asks if Josh will take him to college. He texts him and asks Dalton if it's okay if he takes him to college, and he does. So he drops him off at college. Well, then we kind of go on both of their journeys and how both of them are starting to have memories from the past bleed into the present, and they're starting to get flashes of things that happened. They're starting to uncover things that have happened, and the entire film is them trying to remember what these events are and why this happened to them. And I really enjoyed this movie a lot. It has some really great scares in it, and yes, there are some cheap jump scares. It is an Insidious film, but there are some really tension building moments that I think Patrick Wilson as the director does a really great job pacing this thing out and making the scares actually pay off. This movie really dives into the familial dynamic much more than anything else, where I feel like James Wan in the original Insidious, he gives you a family, and because you see that family be so close together at the beginning, they're tight-knit, that when things start happening to them that are bad, you immediately feel for them because they're just trying to move into a new place, build a life together, and have a family. And in this one, we know this family. We've established through two films together what they've been through, and this is kind of like, okay, everything has broken apart. Everything has been destroyed. All of our relationships aren't the way that they used to be. Can we pick up the pieces and put this back together? Can we kind of work on fixing ourselves? And a lot of the film is an allegory for overcoming trauma, and a lot of that has to do with Dalton's choice in going to college for art. And there's a lot about the art that you make and how your art can be a reflection of the things that have happened to you. And I thought that that was handled really well as well. And I thought that it really resonated through in the third act of the film especially. And we do get some new characters introduced. My favorite new character, Chris, played by Sinclair Daniel, who is the roommate of Dalton at the beginning of the film. She goes in there and he's like, hey, you're a girl. Are we supposed to be in the same room together? She jokes that they're like at a liberal arts college, and the two of them start to form this friendship. She provides a lot of really great comedic punches and moments that I feel like it needs it. She's just very charming and charismatic, and I thought she did a really great job. And I like when franchises this late especially can introduce characters and make them work really well in the story. And it really is these two stories going on at the same time of a father and son trying to figure out what happened in their past. And sometimes that can be to the film's detriment. You jump back and forth in moments, and sometimes you can kind of feel like, okay, maybe this could have lingered on this moment a little bit longer to have more of an emotional punch. But I think with what Patrick Wilson was trying to do here, it is effective for the most part. There are some lulls in the hour and 40 minute runtime that I feel like could have been tidied up a little bit, maybe work a little bit better overall. There's one sequence of events that is meant to scare you that plays off a little bit more comedic than I think Patrick Wilson probably wanted it to. There's like some horrifying elements to the atmosphere of it, but mostly I just found myself kind of chuckling at it, and that's not to say it takes away from the overall film. And this one, it's not like balls to the wall horror like James Wan's original Insidious, where I feel like that movie is an anxiety inducing nightmare where every second something is keeping you on edge and you are so uncomfortable and unsettled that it's just unrelenting is the word I would use for that. And this definitely has more moments that lull you, where it's like, okay, you're just trying to unpack the material, and it's much more about the family elements, like I said. And there are scary moments, and there are real anxiety inducing moments in this that I think work really well for the film, but it is not nearly as scary as the original Insidious. But I don't think that detracts from the overall experience. I think if you're a fan of the original Insidious, this movie is 100% worth checking out. I'm really glad they gave this to someone who actually gives a shit about the property so that they could make something really special. And Patrick Wilson did make a really entertaining film that I had a lot of fun watching, and I'll look forward to revisiting it again sometime in the future. So have you seen Insidious, The Red Door? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Leave me a comment down below and let me know what you thought. I thought this movie was really good. I was really impressed with it. Despite the flaws that I think that the film has, I think that it does a really great job executing exactly what it wants to do. It's scary. It has good character building. It has everything that you could want in a fifth installment of a horror franchise. As always, if you like the video and subscribe to the channel, it helps me out a lot and lets me know the type of content you're looking for. I'm always putting out new material and look forward to getting more out for you in the near future. And as always, everyone, thank you so much for watching and have a great rest of your day.